there's nothing like Scotland, really. The Scottish six-day trial is, like, just mind-blowing, really.
You go through the Scottish Island for 6 days.
Riding over Ben Nevis and Glen Nevis and places you wouldn't ever imagine.
With maybe lap from 100 kilometers to 200 kilometers.
There's no other trial really where you do that sort of mileage, and particularly you don't do 6 days consecutively either.
The goal is to make 30 sections per day. Everyone has the same section. It's just we have an enter, an end, and flags to delimit the boundary of the stream.
The sections are very different from most things really, in the fact that the streams are wide, loose, rough, steep, very slippy, and in tough conditions as well. You have some of the most extreme weather in Scotland. You know, you can have all four seasons in one day. So there really is nothing like Scotland. It's fantastic. It's a week where you can just focus on the riding, have fun. You know, you have highs and lows of life in Scotland. I'm Matthew Alpe, I'm the owner of Inchperfect Trials and the importer and retailer of EM in the UK. Started trials riding when I was about 12 years old. My dad said, oh, if you want a trials bike, you're going to have to buy it yourself. So I used to do everything I could do when I was younger to make money. I used to make dog kennels or roaches after school and sell them. I used to do turkeys at Christmas time and sell them. Sell rock salt when it snowed, tree bars at school. And eventually bought my first bike, which was a Yamaha TY175. You know, I used to practice on that as much as I possibly could do. I then sort of found the limitations when I started going to trials that obviously I could really do with something a bit more modern. So Johnny Smith was the guy who got me into trials, and so I bought his old Beta Rev 3, again saved up for it. Sold my Yamaha TY175 to my dad, and he said he was gonna restore it. So he stripped it all down, put it in boxes, and then it's still upstairs in boxes now. So I think I'm gonna buy that back off him shortly and restore it and put it up on the shelf, maybe off at Inch Perfect, I'm sure. But yeah, once I got my Beta, it was a bit lighter. I used to get up every morning at 6 a.m. I used to practice bouncing round and balancing with no engine on in the barn where we are now. Obviously, I've made it all into a showroom these days, but yeah, it used to be a barn. When I was 15, I approached the Hodder Valley Show, it's a local agricultural show, and I said, oh, me and a friend could be the main arena entertainment, we could put the trials display on. So we got an old tractor trailer with straw bales going at the back of it, built some boxes and a pyramid that was absolutely lethal. You had to wheelie off the other side, otherwise you'd go over the handlebars. And yeah, we did our first show there, it went down really well, and then from there, a guy who used to train me offered me a display wagon. Bought that for a couple of grand in the end, and basically replated all the bottom of the cab, repainted it all, did loads of work on it. It was pretty rotten. You could poke your finger through the bottom of the cab, to be honest with you. When I started doing them training days, someone said, oh, can I hire a bike? So what I used to do was I'd pull a sales bike out for the day, use that on the experience day, mint it all back up, ready for sale again. But one day I had a really good day with the sales, sold all my bikes, and had an experience there the next day. So I had to quickly go out and find any bike I could to buy that. And I was ringing people up and going to all my mates who had trials bikes and buying them. Got the lanyard kill switch on and finished about 2 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, from then I thought, right, I really need to get a fleet of bikes. So started buying some old Shercos, and then eventually built up to a fleet of 10 or 12 old Betas and Shercos. And then in 2017, when Montesa Honda came to me, you know, they wanted me to be a dealer, and they wanted me to use all brand new bikes, you know, to showcase the bikes. So from that point forward, all the bikes were brand new. We change them every 6 months, and you know, it gives the customer the best experience possible. So coming out here, we've got 100 acres of land. People have come back and say, oh, this is the best day I've ever had, and you know, I absolutely loved it. And I love being up here, and you know, all that sort of feedback. You know, it's nice to hear. Means we must be doing a good job. Keep going.
Maybe I'm more stressed for this than for the ride. My name is Gael Chatagno. I come from France. I live in the south of France, and I ride for Electric Motion. It's an electric bike. Start riding trial with my father. My father was the first person who bring me into trial. He rode trial in his early years. I start with a little bike, like a peewee, maybe you know what it is. And after I start a trial with a Gas Gas 50 in 2004. Yeah, so I have around 6 years, I think. Pretty young, yeah, a long time ago, yeah. When I was a child, I was a little bit shy on my own, so I practice a lot of trial on my own or with my dad. We lived at Gemenos, it's a little town near in the south of France, so we can go far and make like a big lap around the mountain and just go to school and see my friend at school. That's a pretty standard life, yeah. When I was young, I really didn't like to lose every game, every, you know, for the family game, all this stuff, I really don't like to lose. But sometimes I am too competitive and I put too much pressure on me or just not enjoy the moment because I just want to win or to perform on what I do. So sometimes it's too much, but yeah, I guess. I rode for Gas Gas and Cherco. I rode in the World Championship in 125. I won the World Championship with Cherco in 2014. And after I go to Gas Gas from 2017 to 2019. I really enjoyed my ride with the petrol bikes too. Very good machine.
My main event each year normally is the Scottish 6-day trial, and with it not being on from 2019 through till 2022, I'd really had 2.5 years off the bike. I'd put quite a bit of weight on, to be honest with you. And you know, come January, I thought, right, I really need to get myself in gear here. So I got a personal trainer, and then I'd say for probably the last 3 or 4 months, I was riding my bike. I was trying to ride 5 mornings a week if I could do. Again, often work got in the way, but for the last sort of 6 weeks since Gael came over in March.
I tried to go on the grippy step,
yeah.
The grey one. Go on this one, and when I feel the grip,
yeah.
On my back wheel, I just go to the left. But I wait, and at last time, I go to the left.
I think it's a bit of a roller coaster as you start training and getting fitter, and I haven't really been riding for the last couple of years. Now I'm getting back into it. You know, you have a bit of doubt in your mind and then you have good days, and today's a good day. So Scotland will be fine. Feeling a lot better now, and the bike's really good. In the stream sections, I feel very planted and it just grips up stuff. And I think for Scotland, it's definitely the best bike for me. I think when I watch Gael through the section and I see how he rides it, and I'm a visual learner so I can try and emulate it. He's very planted on the bike and, you know, he reacts quick and, you know, going up the streams, up the steep stuff, you know, like say the double step we did earlier, Gael really helped me with that. I don't think I would have got that otherwise. So, I think he's helping me more than I'm helping him at the minute. But hopefully my experience in Scotland will pay back the favour.
Me and Gael changing the back.
I think I'm gonna win. Easy. 1 minute. Very, very long.
I need a buzz gun.
Yeah.
Okay, done.
0-2. 2 minutes. 18.
2 minutes 18. Right,
no, okay. It's not bad. It's very good. Very good.
Okay.
Try to be faster. Alright, you take the time.
Same as me. Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Hold up, yeah, go.
You definitely need an air gun for. How long?
43.
Bye. Good. Destroy your ass now.
Also, finish for me. You're professional, I'm part timer.
How long?
1 minute 15. 1 minute 53.
Yeah! I'm doing it!
Close, close! I'm gonna have to up my game on that.
Yeah! Maybe Didier can do it in 1 minute 10 seconds.
Really?
Or maybe 1 minute.
At home, I live in south of France, so we have no water, no stream. The environment is completely different from here. The most, for me, the hardest thing, because it's very different from what we do in France. In France, we have just dry tracks. Here, the moors are like moisture with a lot of water, so sometimes the bike just go very deep in this stuff.
I can't feel the grip, and always I stay stuck in the big bog. Maybe it's the most difficult part for me, this, more than the stream.
Back and lean back a little bit, just so you got a little bit more weight over the back wheel, and so your front wheel's light, so it like just hovers over everything. You stand and you go like this, all hunched up.
How do you do this?
Okay, you go.
No, it wasn't
as bad.
Enough for me.
That was better.
It's hard to, because you need to be all the time concentrate to avoid this such of this mistake. And for 6 hours, so sometimes it's very long. I was just fed up about the most. Sometimes it's maybe the annoying part of the race. This is this. But I was aware for this because everybody said to me, be careful because the most is a very important stuff.
Quite wide, yeah. Looking up. Over that one, carry a bit of momentum.
A bit of momentum, again, and then it was built to the last step.
Yeah.
Just open up, and up. Keeping your head up, don't drop your head.
Yeah.
Standing up nice on the bike.
Yeah.
Can you, when you set off, make a mental note, when you've got your lock like that, you seem to swing yourself and go like that, and, and it's unbalancing you. Can you get your wheel a little bit straighter when you set off? Not over silly, but just make a conscious effort and then it'll set off in a straight line.
Yeah.
Every time you're like that, you have so much work. Immediately then, when you set off in a straight line, I mean just a little, and away we go.
I mean, bike feels mint.
Oh, bike's, you know, absolutely fine.
Yeah, it's just, you know, it's gripping and everything, but I just need to
slow down.
I just need to do little movements rather than big movements.
Exactly.
All the time. Everything's all about that, isn't it?
Yeah.
I come in too deep, I can't get back out again. If I'm swinging, I'm going off.
But how can you set off when you're swinging your handlebars like that? My goodness. Just relax.
I think that's the biggest thing, like, before, when no one were here, I cleaned it straight away.
But you probably, when you've not got an understanding, you probably, on that occasion, set off quite nice. Mm. And then when you were really trying, you're really getting your balance, and then you're doing all this movement.
Mm. When I feel the pressure on me, I'm either one or the other. I either go even better or I go massively worse.
Yeah.
And hopefully by the time I get to start of Scotland, I can go even better. I just need to just keep everything calm, don't I?
Yeah. And ultimately, go up there and enjoy it.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Oh yeah, no, I'm looking forward to it. It will be good.
Yeah.
I just need to not think. I do too much thinking. I just need to not think as much.
Just calm down, enjoy the event for what it is.
Yeah.
And the rides will naturally come. Let's just get it to the finish line.
Yeah, no, I've got
enjoy
no
the week.
The bike.
Yeah.
In the sections, the bike could be
mega. Hmm. And Gael have got that, I just don't back him at all. Check the bikes in, they've done the machine check, marked the special parts that we can't change, which is the frame and the motor, and then now we're just preparing the bags, we're carrying food, drink, you know, a few tools, and yeah, excited, ready to get going. Basically, in the sections I'll be riding in blue or red. Blue is like equivalent to a 250, red's like a 300. So it's fairly flat, nothing too big in it. I'd ride in blue, like at Leenikon, first group Monday morning, bit nervous, very slippy.
Technology moving on,
yeah,
and it's got to be good. It's got to be good for sport.
I think it's great to see electric bikes in the Scottish 6-day trial. It's the future, you know, so we're going to really have to think about that. If the bikes could get round, it's going to be amazing for, you know, for everybody.
We just seen two of them go through there, and yeah, they cleaned it, which is which is a good point. Impressed with how quiet it is. You wouldn't know that it was there.
Do you think it's the future of the sport?
Could be, yeah. It's the way everything else is going, so don't see why not.
Thing with the electric motion is the improvement of the bike all the year, every year. We made a big difference from when I arrived at the factory in 2019 to now.
You watch the petrol bikes and you see them spinning or you see them fighting it. We were just sort of gliding up, particularly Gael, obviously. You know, he was, you know, gliding up the section and just nice and smooth, never spinning and just gripping all the way through.
When you lose the grip, the bike is better because you can manage to ride at very low RPM with or without the clutch, and this is a big difference because the petrol bike. Because with the petrol bike, you always struggle to use the throttle and the clutch at the same time. For the race in Scottish, I think that this bike is maybe the. I don't know because I didn't ride with the petrol one, but it was a very, very good bike in the stream, and we have no problem between the sections, so it's a very good machine for that. I'm very happy to this.
This morning was really good. Just had a slack free just before lunch, but then this afternoon we got a little bit behind on times, just to looking at the sections too long, and so I had to rush a bit, and I could. My legs just weren't just there when I needed them. So tomorrow we know we can go a little bit faster.
That is good. Very good for the day.
Yeah.
Good. Smash it.
Yeah.
rain. Was a little bit cold on the road, but now it's okay. I need to warm up a little bit before the first section, and it will be alright.
To Thursday, I go every day earlier, and Thursday was the most early day. But it's good stuff because everyone has the same condition. So you have an early start, you have a late start, and you have a middle of the pack. It's a very equal race for everybody. And after we go back, maybe on Friday, I go for 12 noon. But I finish late, so we finish at 8 p.m. It's a long day too. But it's easier because the sections are drier.
Today it was a good day. Started off not too good in the sections, are a bit all over the place, but this afternoon I got flowing, and I was quite happy because the last section of the day I managed to clean it. Gael got a 5, so I beat him on that one. But Gael's ridden well. He's had a few dabs himself this morning. It was quite slippy.
I'm not very happy with this day because the start was a little was bad. I took 4 points in our section, but I can do it better than this, and I took 2 more points in easy section, and after I ride quite well until the end. I took a 5 on the last section, an easy section.
He only dropped 2 marks, but sadly he got a 5 in the last section for stopping, where he didn't actually stop, so I took him from 3rd place to 19th place. But it's just one of those things that happens, self-service decision. So he's got to work extra hard now to try and pull himself back up there. All in all, a good day, no problem with the bikes, absolutely faultless. And coming down all them moors off the mountains, we've been able to regen off the PRBR, so coming down there, using that and getting loads of power back into the batteries, swapped at each fuel stop, and jobs are good and ready for tomorrow.
Plus, tomorrow we will restart sooner, so the section where will be more slippery. So we have to deal with that for tomorrow and Friday and Thursday. So keep pushing for the next day.
All the night I was angry about this fight because I knew that it will drag me down in the ranking. But yeah, I'm a professional rider, so I had a lot of deception in my life in competition. So when I was young, it was very hard for me, this kind of stuff, because I just think about this for maybe 2 or 3 days or maybe more. Now I know how to make the difference between this is the race, this is after, you need to relax. So I was pissed off, but finally I managed to just relax the night and to go back the day after, because it's a long race, you need to be efficient every day.
In the over the 50s are intrigued by it, and then when they try it, They're either intrigued or they're like, oh no, I don't want to have a go on that.
I'm 54, and we've lived the generation of having the most amount of power available, unlimited.
But when they actually have a go on it, they're mind blown and like, blimey, I can't believe how good it is. They're always, always impressed.
Unfortunately, I think it's going to be the future. I work in the renewable industry, so I'm supposed to be supporting decarbonisation and stuff, but the reason I ride a Ford RT is because I like the noise as much as anything else, so yeah, we'll see. There's definitely something to be interested in the future.
They like the noise, don't they? Which is something that I think that we've grown up with over the last 100 years.
This gentleman, Scott Ellis, from Derbyshire, he's been a winner of many national trials in the 60s, late 50s, Scott?
Yeah.
Late 50s and 60s.
Yeah, used to ride this trial some time ago. I think the best position was third one year.
I can remember taking photographs of him in the Nuts trial in early 60s, riding a Tiger Cub.
Yeah.
And very famous for having the world's most tatty hat riding in trials, long before we had to wear crash helmets. It was the most disgusting looking thing you've ever seen. And my dad, who I used to go to trials with, used to say, don't you ever let your hats get as bad as that.
Hard day today. I was low on energy this morning and it took me really until later on this afternoon to get going. I had some good rides in the first group, and then second and third group I were just had no strength in my legs. I were all over the place, but that's where the bike really helped me, really, because you know I was offline on the slippery stuff and the way this thing grips I were getting away with a lot. But bike's faultless, just the man that needs to improve. But I'm going to have something good to eat tonight and just try and recover, because we've got a big day tomorrow. Tomorrow's like the biggest day, really. Mainly all on the moors, it'll be like 100 odd miles. We've got new front tyre on for tomorrow, new rear, so it should be gripping well. Yeah, make life as easy as we can, because it's going to be a big day.
It's supposed to rain all day tomorrow.
Thanks for that, yeah. Cheers. I was just feeling good until you said that.
Pretty good day, start not very good because I've got a crash in the moors, trying to keep up with Matthew, and my rear wheel just locked, and I did this in the big hill, and just fall down like this, and maybe slide for 10 or 20 meters.
And people saw me crash and they come to me and say, yeah, it's all right, no problem. Yeah, I say, you know, no problem. And we laugh about this all the day because they remember my crash. It's a pretty good one, yeah. And the bike was grass everywhere on the bike, and we need to fix the bike after the crash. So we lost maybe 15 minutes for that. Normally you have staff, but here to make equality between every rider, each rider needs to fix his own bike after the race. You have only 20 minutes if you have early, and only 20 minutes the morning before the start, so it's a very close time to fix the bike.
You can lose 1 minute in this race. This is incredible because I never did that before. Normally in a normal trial race like the World Championship, you have a lot of time to look at the section, to rest, to take some food. But the sections are harder, but you have more time. And now you just rush all the day to finish on time. So it's very hard for me to do this. But finally, with Matthew, we keep a very good pace all the day to go on time just after this crash. But it's good, and I rode quite well in the section. Feel just a little bit tired at the end of the day, maybe for the 10 last section. The body feel a little bit weak, but I managed to clean most of the section. So yeah, maybe 5 points overall for the day. Maybe I was 20 yesterday, maybe I can go a little bit forward in the ranking, maybe 15, I hope for 15. And now we have to rest a lot because tomorrow is the biggest day. And we start very early, so the section will be slippery. And we have to manage to put the lower point possible during the day.
The electric bike's absolutely brilliant. I like the clutch action and the tickover ability. They had time in the section, they weren't snatchy, there wasn't too much power, found grip, well balanced. Just seeing them go on the road now, really good on the road. And something really to consider if you're thinking about a new bike and you didn't like fettling with a carburetor every time or cleaning air filters.
Filling it with petrol, all these things that take a lot of time. So for someone like myself who's running a business who doesn't have that time, you can't beat it.
For me, for example, at home, I did the mechanic once in a week for maybe 20 minutes. I just washed the bike, tight the bolt and put some grease on the axis and the chain and no more. When I rode for the petrol bike, I took maybe 4 hours per week to fix the bike every week, so it's a huge difference. I like this because sometimes the mechanic is annoying because you do all the time the same stuff. So for this, the bike is very, very good.
I think it's certainly a bike to consider for the future.
Gael and Matthew, they're going really well. I'm sort of up front, keeping an eye out for what's coming up next, giving the lads a bit of a lowdown on how they're getting on. But fair play to them, they're cracking on, and only today and tomorrow to go, and then we're across that finish line.
I think electric bikes are a great idea. I think that maybe in 3 or 4 years' time, it's all you're going to see here. I think they're going to complete it, yeah, yeah. I've seen the boys going up quite a few big stuff. I've seen them going up Trotters Burn and stuff.
I've messed that section up so many times in the past and I was determined to clean it. I come up that, got right underneath the bottom of the step, revved it flat out and shot out the top and cleaned it, and the crowd were going clapping like mad, and made it even better because Gael managed to cock this section up and fived it, so I beat him on that day on that section.
Thursday was our early start. We start at 7:40. The section were not very hard, except maybe one or two, but we are very close on time. I just come back in the minutes.
Thursday is always a big long day, and obviously we were first men out, so the sections were slippy. But the moors were all right because there's not been too many people for him. Gael had his first experience of the moors, so he was finding it rough, but I sort of knew what to expect, and you know it was fine. It was tight on time, we had to really push at the end and literally got Gael in on the minute. I might have just got a few time penalty points, but I'm not so bothered about me, I'm more bothered about Gael.
Quite a long day yesterday. We were 110 miles, a lot of moor work, a lot of track work, and as we arrived into the second to last petrol shed before the last group of sections, first hit, we unfortunately got a batch of diesel in the bike, so it cost us a good bit of time. We obviously set off, we had no clue, set off with it in the bikes, down the track, and the bike stopped, so pushing back up to the fuel check to get a fresh batch of actual petrol. And then cracking on. I'm pretty sure it's never happened in Scotland before and it'll never happen again.
So we got to the fuel stop and all the petrol bikes were all parked up, and all the lads said, we filled our bikes up with diesel. So obviously we didn't have that problem, we just put our batteries in and off we went. We'd done a lot of testing before Scotland, and obviously I've ridden EM for like the last couple of years. And one thing I want to make clear is that obviously, if you go and do a normal trial, you normally finish with somewhere between 45 to 65% left on one battery, and that's doing the expert route. And obviously with Scotland, because of the length of the day, because of the duration, because of the distance and the speed we were going, obviously we're changing the batteries at the fuel checks, but I don't want people to think, oh, I need to get a lot of batteries to be able to go and do an event. That isn't the case. You go and do a normal trial or a normal club trial, or you know, you don't need any spare batteries whatsoever. Like I say, the lowest I've ever finished on a big lap club trial was up in Richmond just before Scotland actually.
So I started at 10:30 this morning. It's 1:30 now. It's 84%, so we used 16%. So full trial, no problem. And probably I would have thought I'll finish with easily 55-50%.
The bike I was using had the PRBR on, so coming down all the hills, it's a progressive regen brake. I'm pulling that in rather than the rear brake pedal. It's putting power back into the battery. Basically over the space of a full day, I'm using it 95% of the time, and it's putting 20-30% back in. We didn't know exactly, because you know, obviously the ground is so undulating, and you know, some steep climbs and the moors and everything else. So many different factors, and so our aim was obviously to go fuel stop to fuel stop, which we succeeded in doing. We did have a support crew as well, just with backup batteries in case we needed them, and on the odd occasion that we did use one, we didn't actually need it because we'd go around the corner and a fuel stop would be there, so then we'd miss that fuel stop and go to the next one. The longest range that I recorded on my thing was on the road. It was on Friday morning, road race day, and we did 17.5 miles. I think I took a photograph of my speedometer, I couldn't believe it. And I still had about 20% left as well. I actually think as the week went on and we got more and more cycles through the batteries got even better. So just completed Friday. First group of the day was scrapped due to deep water, and same with the last group of the day. So it's a shame because EM would have really shone in the deep water where the Pepper Wise Man sucked a bit of water in. But anyway, we've had a good day. Gail's ridden well. I think he's only dropped 2 or 3 marks today. I've had a few more than that. I'm feeling a little bit tired, but I got going again this afternoon, and last few groups have been good. So. Yeah, we've nearly done, well, it's over 100 miles today. Again, bike's been faultless. It's been no problem at all. Battery changes at the fuel stops have been no problem. And yeah, all good really. Enjoying it. On to tomorrow, last day. Nearly smashed it. Week I've had in Scotland, as far as I've not had one single issue with the bike. We come back on a night, we blow it off, I give it a clean, and I'm looking around in it thinking, oh, what else do I need to do? You know, I lubricate the chain. We've, out of choice, I've changed the chain and I've changed tyres, and that's it. I was saying to the lads before, we could literally have done Scotland with same chain, same tyres, all week. You know, I ain't had to change brake pads, I ain't had to change oil, I ain't had to have a carburetor off, I ain't had to, you know, clean the air filter, drown the bike and drain all the water out of it. You just don't have them problems at all. Yeah, it's been fantastic. And as far as the section goes, it's unbelievable. The way that thing grip, you just get away with so much and you get so many chances, you know. Like towards, I'd say Wednesday, I was feeling tired and I was all over the place with my body, but I still was cleaning the sections because I'd get offline and the bike would give me time to get back online and bring the power in smooth and get going again. I don't believe there is a better bike you could ride Scotland on. It is fantastic.
Struggling with tendonitis the last 3 days. Gutting, to be honest, because I've been riding really well the last 2 days, Friday, Saturday. I've just not been able to push in the sections at all, so a little bit gutted. But yeah, that's trials, unfortunately. Sometimes you're in such a controversial. Let's see these boys cross the line in a few minutes' time.
Managed to finish the trial no problem. So obviously we've been riding the EM 2022 Epure Race and it's been absolutely faultless all week. We've not had one issue. They grip fantastically well in the sections, so there's been times where the body's been tired and I've been offline, but we managed to get away a bit with just the way with the bike grips and digs in and goes. And obviously with Gael's result, it's shown what they can really do. That was my role in Scotland really, was to pass on my 7 years of experience to Gael and try and help him as much as possible. He'd only really done 1 week of training in the stream sections. Other than that, he'd never ridden in a stream hardly in his life, and especially not slippery ones. So for him to finish 19th was a phenomenal result. And obviously he got the best foreign rider. So yeah, he'd done really well. Like he said, and I agree with him, I don't think we could have been on a better bike. Having ridden Scotland myself on other bikes, I know that it was definitely a lot easier for me.
Very happy with how the bike worked. All the week, all the team did an incredible job, so I'm very happy with our project. Very good.
It's nice to be back up here with all the boys, so I've definitely missed it the last couple of years. But yeah, it has been a fantastic week as always. We're riding, it's been good in places, not so good in others. I'll definitely be back for another crack next year. Yeah, electric bikes, I've been very surprised all week, to be honest. I weren't a pessimist at the start or anything, but the way Gael's been riding that in place has been absolutely amazing, to be honest with you. So it definitely looks bright for the future.
And like I say, as much as anything, it's a fun factor riding that bike. It's like nothing else really. Yeah, but you've got to try it to believe it. I think after people seeing how me and Gael have ridden this year, I think there'll be quite a few wanting to ride Scotland on an EM. We're going to have to speak to the organisers and the army and EM themselves and, you know, decide what we're going to do and how we're going to go about it. Privateers who want to do the event, that again will be a service that will become available over the next few years. We'll probably limit the number of riders we can offer it to, but for those wanting to do it, then, you know, that's the route we go down. In my personal opinion, I think they're already better than the petrol bikes at, like I say, our level and the level of 95% of the trials riders out there, and I think everyone would ride one better, just the way they grip and everything. But like I say, at that top level, that's where they're still slightly behind, and that's where Gael's going to push it forward and hopefully smash it this year.
Very good week for us, a lot of good memories in my mind, and I want to thank Inch Perfect Trail and Electric Motion in UK for their amazing job all the week. They did a mega job. I thank also Didier, my mechanic, who come with me, drive all around France and England to bring me to this event. And thanks to my factory to allow me to do such of good moments in trial, so it was mega. I hope to come back again. I don't know when, but I think I will come back one day.
You know, like I say, I think we've conquered the hardest trial you can do. You know, so from here on in, it's easy really. just about having fun and riding our bikes.